Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Pinky and Rex and the New Neighbors by James Howe. Narrated by Christina Moore.
Chapter 1. Bad News. The first Rex heard about it was from her babysitter. Mara was putting fingernail polish on Rex at the time, something Rex allowed only Mara to do, because she used cool colors like green and purple. At the moment, Mara was painting Rex's nails blue with sparkles.
"Good news about Mrs. Morgan, isn't it?" Mara said, referring to Rex's neighbor.
"What news?"
Rex asked. "Haven't you heard?" Mara seemed surprised.
"She's moving.
Now maybe you'll have somebody nice living next door."
Without thinking, Rex twisted her body away to look in the direction of Mrs. Morgan's house.
"Careful," Mara said.
"Sorry,"
said Rex, giving her hand back to the babysitter.
I didn't know Mrs. Morgan was moving."
Mara studied Rex's face.
"Aren't you glad? You look almost sad or something."
Rex shrugged.
"I am, sort of."
"But why? She's a mean old witch, remember?"
Rex remembered that a mean old witch was what all the kids in the neighborhood had once called Mrs. Morgan. It wasn't a nice name, but it fit her. She had been mean. But then she changed. She'd become a special friend to Rex and her best friend, Pinky. She gave them cookies and lemonade on hot days, cookies and cocoa on cold ones. She had shown them faded photographs of herself when she was their age, and given each of them a book from her childhood with her name printed inside the front cover in pencil.
"She's not so bad," Rex said at last.
Mara, who had been Rex's babysitter since she was little, shook her head.
"That's not what you used to say."
"I know, but I like her now."
Mara put the last drop of polish on Rex's nails and closed the bottle.
"So I guess it isn't good news," she said.
"No," said Rex.
She just couldn't imagine the house next door without Mrs. Morgan in it.
Chapter 2. For Sale.
Pinky couldn't imagine it either. "I thought she'd always be there," he said to Rex as they played in Rex's backyard.
"Me too," said Rex.
"Did you see the sign?"
Pinky nodded. A for sale sign had gone up in front of Mrs. Morgan's house that morning.
"I wonder who's going to move in," Rex went on.
"Maybe they'll have kids," Pinky said. Suddenly he was worried.
"We'll still be best friends, right?"
"Of course."
"Even if a girl moves in next door?"
Rex gave Pinky a look.
"Don't be dumb," she said.
Pinky smiled. Mrs. Morgan shouted hello from her backyard. Pinky and Rex went running. Minutes later, they were helping her set up her easel.
"I never realized there were so many things in this yard I wanted to paint," Mrs. Morgan said. "And now I have so little time to do it."
"You could come back to visit," said Rex.
Mrs. Morgan smiled sweetly at her young friend.
"I don't think the new people would care to have me roaming around their yard with my paints and easel," she said.
"Who are the new people?" Pinky asked.
"I have no idea," Mrs. Morgan replied. "No one has even looked at the house yet. But someone will buy it, and then it will be theirs."
"Oh, my,"
she said with a sudden faraway look in her eyes.
"It won't be mine anymore. After 37 years.
Imagine that."
"Why do you have to move?" Pinky asked.
"I don't," she answered. "But I want to. Now, don't take that the wrong way. I'm not tired of my neighbors. It's just that when you get to be my age, it becomes harder to take..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.